Tech, tech, tech. Good morning. It is the Mountain Report, and outside Andy serenading us this morning, providing the background music, copyright free. And it is 28 degrees here as we start the day off on this Easter weekend. And look, we got like all kinds of happy dogs out there. If Kip had a tail, that's him right there, that'd be wagging like that, but it'd be creepy. At Mountside Real Estate, bringing this live quad cam shot this morning. And it's, you know, we're gonna see some sunshine this afternoon, but we're gonna see a fresh breeze here this morning. That's what they call it, a fresh breeze. But as you can see, Supercord not running yet. Captain Kip joining us here. That could be him right now, as a matter of fact. Let's take a Kip is joining us here this morning. And hey, Kip, you're live. So don't say anything bad about me or anyone else. Now, who can you tell us about your friends out there, all the doggies? What's going on out there?
Well, it's a WSKI fan club. They meet the last Saturday in March every year.
Yeah, they come and pee on your leg.
Oh, they sniff. They run around. They're having a great time. Because there's not much skiing going on here. It was blowing, I don't know, gust of 50, a little over 50 here at the top of Super Quad. So everything from the base lodge up pretty much is shut down. But I think Sawduster and Snubber are working. I know that you can get your favorite trails off of that. And the Mooskalator. I have no idea about the weather, if this is going to abate. I've seen two different reports. Some say after lunch, and some said not till after dark. So we'll see how it goes. Just keep tuned to SKI or the Sugarloaf webpage for the updates. The ski patrol has gone up, a couple of snowmobiles. If they get back, I can give you some conditions report. I'm not sure if the uphill, because there's no ski patrol up there, really, on station, where the uphill is even available yet today. But check in on the webpage to find that out. One thing I do know is that some great spring sales going on at the Downhill Supply Company. All the demos, which these are right here, these vocals, they're all on sale right now. First come, first serve. So if you want to go in, either up to the Sugar Shack or right into the Downhill Supply Company across from the bag, go in, and you've tried a pair of skis, you like them, you can get some demos. These are the Kenjos. They're 84 underfoot vocal. They're really kind of a front face carver, groomers. If you're not going in the woods or wiggling your legs down Skidder or, you know, out of Bracket Basin, and you're staying on the groomers, this is one great ski. You could try this, if you get up the hill today or tomorrow, and if you like them, you can buy this exact pair. And some of them haven't been used at all. The last time these were used was because of the length on them. I used them about a month and a half ago. Oh, you can get some great deals on some really, really good skis, and they even have some boots left over. The best time, of course, to buy boots is in the spring. In the fall, right when they have all the sizes and stuff. But they have some limited stuff. Go in and check it out. There's some as much as 20% off. Some items as much as 50% off. So. Go in and try them. I got word from Michelle at the bag that the Mahogany Ridge is groomed out and very nicely taken care of today. So if you want to go into the fun. Perfect. Well groomed.
We appreciate it. We hope you get up the hill to try out those skis for us.
I do. I would like to. It's the only reason it's chilly out here, Greg, is because of the wind. Other than that, it'd be pretty mild.
All right, well, we'll look forward to your next report. Get yourself a pair of signature Captain Kip skis, maybe even on sale. We'll get another report from Captain Kip coming up. But first, we're going to throw it to outside Andy. We kind of just shook it up this morning, didn't we, Andy?
I don't even know where I am.
You don't know where you are. Well, you're at the weather desk. And we're going to throw it to Outside Andy at the weather desk.
The WSKI TV 17 Weather Report is brought to you by Mountainside Real Estate. Visit them in the village or online at sugarloafmountainside.com. Good morning, skiers and riders, Sugarloaf and Carabasset Valley. Time to take a check of your latest local forecast. You can find this and much more at our website, WSKITV.com, including streaming and much more. And it's going to be a windy day today, especially this morning. We'll see sunshine start to poke through as the day goes on, 32 to 34 for your base temperatures with a west wind 10 to 20 miles an hour. Summit temperatures 23 to 25 with a gusty west-northwest breeze causing issues first thing. So stay tuned to the Mountain Report. We'll keep you updated on what's happening outside. For the day on Sunday, we'll wake up with some clouds, but things should clear out to sunny skies by the afternoon. A high of 38 at the base. Summit temperatures topping out right around 30 degrees, the upper 20s, and we'll still have a noticeable breeze across the hill, so just be aware of that. First day of April, we're looking for sunny skies, a high of 43 degrees. Tuesday, increase in clouds with a high of 40. And then Wednesday, looks like another snowstorm headed into our area, which is some great news. We'll keep skiing and riding right into the spring. Birchwood Interiors bringing you your trail report. Check them out in Village West. 149 trails to ski and ride on. 10 lifts getting you to 41 groomed trails. We'll see loose, granular, and variable conditions out there if you can get out on the hill. First thing this morning, scheduled winds, weather, and conditions permitting, Snubber, Sawduster, Skidway, and the Mooskalator, as well as Skyline and Double Runner East, and the Super Quad at 8:30, King Pine and Whiffletree at 8:30 as well, servicing the east side. And make note, Bucksaw Express is closed today and tomorrow. Timberline, winds, weather, and conditions permitting, opening at 9 a.m. Timberline, Bridal Chain, Tote Road, King's Landing, Hayburner, Haywire, Comp Hill, and Narrow Gauge on the groomers list last night, as well as Spillway, Sluice, Gondola Line, and Wedge, as well as Hallback and Ramdown on the east side, lower east side trails like Two-Haul, Whiffletree, Cruiser, Lower Buckboard, Slasher Pole Line, Springboard, and Rollway, and Scoot, Windrow, Horseshoe, and West Mountain over on the west side of the mountain, as well as the new Bucksaw Trail to get you back down to the parking lot. And Lower Winter's Way, Candyside Boardwalk, the Landing, Birches, and Snowbrook around the base area, and all the terrain parks get smoothed out as well. The uphill route is open. Just follow the designated route. And down to the Sugarloaf Outdoor Center, they're still holding on. They've been grooming out there. Things are firming up, though, with the cooler temperatures and the wet snow. The Anti-Gravity Complex, great spot for indoor activity, as well as the Sugarloaf Sports and Fitness Center right off of Mountainside Road or the Snubber Trail. And today is Clem and Roland Began. They're having a little shindig for them, 1 o'clock to 2:30 at the Carabasset Valley Public Library and Community Center in the Began Community Room. And there's an open house on Elderberry Way today, offered up by Liz Walker-Feeney, and also Fodder's Market and Hardware. If you're looking for any of your Easter supplies, they've got it right up on Main Street in Stratton. Make note, they will be closed on Easter Sunday. And a great Easter sunrise service on Sunday. Get up early, go grab a ticket, and be at the Super Quad to load at 5:30. And that's always a good time to get up there early on the Super Quad to celebrate Easter. Quad Cam, check it out so you can see what's happening at the mountain in real time with some weather information on there as well. And we've got our mountain report this weekend, Saturday and Sunday morning, 7:30 to 9 a.m. We've got Watch and Win Reggae Weekend, and there's plenty of ways to watch us right here on Channel 17, as well as streaming 24/7 at WSKITV.com, the Spectrum app, as well as a Roku channel, and check us out on social media as well. Make the most of it today, folks.
I'm Jeff Kennedy, designated broker for Mountainside Real Estate. I've been a Sugarloafer since 1984. I actually came here as an intern out of Penn State. I fell in love with the area and I've been here ever since. Well, I've actually been selling real estate for Sugarloaf since 1984. And that just gives you a wealth of experience. And we know the people, we know the owners here. I mean, I've been here 40 years, you get to know everybody. We're on Main Street in the village, open 7 days a week, 8:30 to 5, come see us.
Back at the Mountain Report, that is our live quad cam shot, which I don't know how many people, Andy, hundreds of thousands of people maybe for the eclipse might be looking at this and visiting our website as we're streaming there, also on Roku and on the Spectrum app, good old Channel 17, and on the Spectrum subscription app. Mountainside Real Estate bringing this live quad cam shot, and we have got things to talk about, things happening around and about. Yeah, you just got to hang out, have an extra cup of Carabasset coffee, and wait it out until all the lifts are going to, well, we'll let you know all the lifts that are going to run. Here's some good news. When the lifts are and when the staffing is able to get up there, the CVA T-Bar is going to be available for our guests, and that is good news, and I'm sure you'll enjoy that. That's going to be something, a little bonus today. Also, don't forget Easter service coming up, but we got lots of things to talk about here. Let's take a look in indoor activities galore, of course, and summer help too. You know, think about that. Pool director, assistant camp director needed, and Carabasset Public Library. Total solar eclipse, Gulf of Maine Research Institute. That's going to be happening, a presentation down at the library. And the Sport and Fitness Center is open, hot tub, swimming pool, weight room, more. And they got a cafe, opens at 7 o'clock. Open daily, Downhill Supply Company equipment, tuning and repair, and deals, as the captain highlighted this morning. Birchwood Interiors, magnificent living at affordable prices. That's right, you can visit and do the same. And Carabasset Coffee is open. Call ahead, pick up your coffee, and they have a sign out there. They don't serve coffee there. They just sell coffee. And end of the season sale, Julie is going to come in and talk about more what's available down in Kingfield at her shop. And Farmers Market, they've got all you need for decorating eggs. They got the white eggs, and all you gotta do is just paint them up. And you can get also information on rooms, and they've got places to stand to watch the eclipse at Spillover. And open house, 2 to 4 today, 5008 Elderberry Way, and you can go and check that out today. This is an event happening 1 o'clock till 2:30 at the library, and some words of appreciation for Clem and Roland Began, who did some great things around here at the Rack Spruce Mountain. It is the Dark Side of the Moon skis are going to give them away, and going to have some Pink Floyd music at the Rack. Of course, the bar, the breakfast shack is open, and Easter service happens tomorrow. You'll want to board, but it's open at 5, and it will be 5:30 till 5:35, and you can check out the Easter service on Mountain. All of these social medias, you can find us, and of course on YouTube where we're streaming, perhaps millions of people watching right now. So we are so excited about that eclipse. We went out and talked to a lot of people. A lot of people got some great things going on. And we are going to, we're going to have an influx of some people. I am told the policy at the mountain is going to be once the access road is filled, that's it. They're
first
filled.
First come, first serve.
First come, first serve. Remember to carpool. You might want to do that. If you can. And Jess is going to join us, talk more about that and other things happening this weekend. We got a report from a ski patrol here in just a moment. We're going to give you some great ideas of food to eat, where to go, and more. Stay with us. It's the Mountain Report. We're here at the Rack, bottom of the access road, visiting with the sign, and just want to let you know, busy weekend here with Primal Soup on Friday, and then Saturday, it is the Pink Floyd experience. Now, there's more to it than that. Ski Depot has been giving away, actually, they're raising money for Spruce Mountain. It's a benefit, and you can get tickets to win Dark Side of the Moon skis. I got my ticket, and you want to win those skis, you want to be here, get your ticket, and experience the Pink Floyd experience here at the Rack. And remember, the Rack Rescue Shack is open for biz in the morning. You can check it out, get some great barbecue sandwiches right here at the Rack. They open at 7 a.m. this weekend at the Rack.
New Year fun at the Shipyard Brewhouse, a slopeside delight for skiers and snowboarders alike. We're serving up breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So stop in before, after, or in between your runs. The beer's always flowing and the good times are rolling. So check our website for midweek specials and the live music schedule. I pray all day with cold brews and mountain views at the Shipyard Brewhouse.
What's your favorite thing to eat here at the Bag?
Bag Burger.
Bag Burger.
You love the baked potato, actually.
Half in the bag punch.
I love the lifty lemonade.
Cheeseburger soup, very good.
Pepperoni pizza.
Burger.
burger.
Yeah, Valentine.
Pastrami sandwiches.
Chicken wings.
Bag burger.
Cheese pizza.
Bag burger.
Whatever's on the menu.
All of it.
The Town of Carrabassett Valley Summer Trail Crew is hiring for both experienced and new employees for this summer. The crew is responsible for building and maintaining the growing bicycle trail network in the region. Do you enjoy working outside? Do you have experience operating heavy equipment? Or do you participate in the sport of mountain biking and are looking to learn the skills and art of trail building with your own two hands? Well, we are looking for you. The town is an equal opportunity employer who provides competitive pay and flexible scheduling. Ideal candidates include recent high school or college grads, those with experience with small engine tools or heavy equipment, and those looking to begin or expand upon a growing career opportunity offered in the challenging forest economies of the Northeast region. Please visit the Recreation Department page on the town website at CarrabassettValley.org for more information or to apply. We look forward to hearing from you.
Backco Financial is an independent wealth management firm here in Falmouth. We pride ourselves on building trustworthy, long-term relationships so that we can be the first call our clients make when they have questions about investments, finance, and life changes. Our team has a variety of expertise and professional designations that allow us to provide holistic financial planning and tailored asset management. Backco Financial, honest, independent, experienced.
We are back. It's the Mountain Report. Thanks for joining us here this morning. My name is Greg Powers, living the dream on this Easter weekend. And I just want to review again Easter service. If you have a pass, you'll be all right. If you don't have a pass, you're going to want to go over to guest services. Now, things are going to start waking up around here between 5 and 5:20. You'll be able to load at 5:30 till 5:35, and then it will stop and it'll be quiet so that you can really enjoy the peacefulness of the mountain. And hopefully we'll see the sunrise. And it's a great opportunity to get out there and enjoy it. Many people do each and every year. It's been going on for a very long time, and it is a great thing for you to experience up there on the hill. We've got let's talk about some things to eat, shall we?
Yes.
We could, and why not? You know, because the shipyard. They've got breakfast right now, 7 till 10, lunch 11 to 9. And Thursday through Sunday, they got pizza and beer delivery right there on the hill. Java Joe's, got your favorite cup of coffee, open at 7 a.m. Deli's, they're open with hearty breakfasts, but not just that, much, much more. Sandwiches, paninis, and four different ways to order. Today will be Robin Cottle, 3 to 6 at 45 North. And Saturday and Sunday, 11 to 1, got a brunch going on, the Rack Rescue breakfast sandwich. Saw Sarah putting the big sign out on the truck. There she is. She's ready for you. And, of course, the Spruce Mountain Benefit and Pink Floyd celebration tonight at the Rack. And Friday, whiskey each and every Friday. And they have got entertainment on Sunday. Bowinkles is open daily. Their entertainment is not happening today. The halfway, the warm-up for reggae. And Triple Creek, 3 to 6 at the Widowmaker upstairs in the Base Lodge. Check it out. And Mas Amigos in Village West with a great happy hour, 3 to 4, and delicious Mexican fare, Wednesday through Sunday, 11 to 9. And the Mountainside Grocers, located at the bottom of the access road. And we're going to talk with Sarah here this morning on the program. Sugar Bowl's open. And they have got every Sunday, 2 to 4, CVA bowling. Join them. That's right. I bet they're competitive. Looney Moose, they're going to be open. And on Eclipse Day, they're going to be open for breakfast. And they want to make sure everyone gets fed, so they'll stay open if there's more people waiting. Flagstaff General Store, Rotisserie Tuesday. That's one of my favorite days of the week. And at the White Wolf Inn, Eclipse glasses, T-shirts. They are so into it. We'll bring you more on that this morning. And the Pines Market, located on Route 27 in Eustace. Everything you need for a day out on the trails or hiking or whatever you're doing in the trails. And Steakhouse, Eclipse Weekend Friday, the fifth outdoor event. They'll be sitting out on the deck and getting dark. That's right. And this is the aspect button right there. We just showed you that, and it'll, like, fill the screen. But my recommendation is you watch on Roku, because that already happens for you. So much more to talk about. We'll talk about a ski patrol once again when the lifts are running, and they are not right now, but when they are, the CVA T-Bar, Bobby came in and told us that's going to be available for guests.
Sunrise service video from 20 years ago.
Really?
Yes.
I must have been so young.
Yeah, you weren't even
Sunday service.
The
Super Quad was great. So 20 years ago, there was a Sunrise service. And, you know, we kind of specialize in old footage sometimes. Here it is.
WSKI TV 17 Weather Report is brought to you by Mountainside Real Estate. Visit them in the village or online at sugarloafmountainside.com. Good morning, skiers and riders, Sugarloaf and Carabasset Valley. Time to take a check of your latest local forecast. You can find this and much more at our website, WSKITV.com, including streaming and much more. And it's going to be a windy day today, especially this morning. We'll see sunshine start to poke through as the day goes on, 32 to 34 for your base temperatures, with a west wind 10 to 20 miles an hour. Summit temperatures 23 to 25 with a gusty west northwest breeze causing issues first thing. So stay tuned to the Mountain Report. We'll keep you updated on what's happening outside. For the day on Sunday, we'll wake up with some clouds, but things should clear out to sunny skies by the afternoon. A high of 38 at the base, summit temperatures topping out right around 30 degrees, the upper 20s, and we'll still have a noticeable breeze across the hill, so just be aware of that. First day of April, we're looking for sunny skies, a high of 43 degrees. Tuesday, increase in clouds with a high of 40. And then Wednesday looks like another snowstorm headed into our area, which is some great news. We'll keep skiing and riding right into the spring. Birchwood Interiors bringing you your trail report. Check them out in Village West. 149 trails to ski and ride on. 10 lifts getting you to 41 groomed trails. We'll see loose, granular, and variable conditions out there if you can get out on the hill. First thing this morning, scheduled winds, weather, and conditions permitting, Snubber, Sawduster, Skidway, and the Mooskalator, as well as Skyline and Double Runner East, and the Super Quad at 8:30, King Pine and Whiffletree at 8:30 as well, servicing the east side. And make note, Bucksaw Express is closed today and tomorrow. Timberline, winds, weather, and conditions permitting, opening at 9 a.m. Timberline, Bridal Chain, Tote Road, King's Landing, Hayburner, Haywire, Comp Hill, and Narrow Gauge on the Groomers list last night, as well as Spillway, Sluice, Gondola Line, and Wedge, as well as Hallback and Ramdown on the east side, lower east side trails like Two-Haul, Whiffletree, Cruiser, Lower Buckboard, Slasher, Pole Line, Springboard, and Rollway, and Scoot, Windrow, Horseshoe, and West Mountain over on the west side of the mountain, as well as the new Bucksaw Trail to get you back down to the parking lot. And Lower Winter's Way, Candyside Boardwalk, the Landing, Birches, and Snowbrook around the base area, and all the terrain parks get smoothed out as well. The uphill route is open. Just follow the designated route. And down at the Sugarloaf Outdoor Center, they're still holding on. They've been grooming up there. Things are firming up, though, with the cooler temperatures and the wet snow. The Anti-Gravity Complex, great spot for indoor activity, as well as the Sugarloaf Sports and Fitness Center right off of Mountainside Road or the Snubber Trail. And today is Clem and Roland Began. They're having a little shindig for them, 1 o'clock to 2:30 at the Carabasset Valley Public Library and Community Center in the Beacon Community Room. And there's an open house on Elderberry Way today, offered up by Liz Walker-Feeney. And also, Fodder's Market and Hardware. If you're looking for any of your Easter supplies, they've got it right up on Main Street in Stratton. Make note, they will be closed on Easter Sunday. And a great Easter sunrise service on Sunday. Get up early, go grab a ticket, and be at the Super Quad to load at 5:30. And that's always a good time to get up there early on the Super Quad to celebrate Easter. Quad Cam, check it out so you can see what's happening at the mountain in real time with some weather information on there as well. And we've got our mountain report this weekend, Saturday and Sunday mornings, 7:30 to 9 a.m. We've got Watch and Win Reggae Weekend, and there's plenty of ways to watch us right here on Channel 17, as well as streaming 24/7 at WSKITV.com, the Spectrum app, as well as a Roku channel, and check us out on social media as well. Make the most of it today, folks.
Hello, I'm Earl Morris, owner of Birchwood Interiors. For 31 years, we've been providing you, our fellow Sugarloafers, with furniture, flooring, mattresses, and window treatments. But what many Sugarloafers don't realize is the amount of construction and new renovation work that we do. From fireplaces to kitchens to bathrooms and steam showers, we do anything inside the walls of a house. We love what we do and hope you'll shop locally with us.
We are back, and you know, Kip is such a team player that he was out stomping and helping out the crew. There he is, just like a supervisor. He's coming out, he's helping out. And we want to let you know, as we start the day off, 28 degrees, and all lifts are on Windhoek currently, except Muscalator, Sawduster, Skidway, and are going to run. And the CVA T-Bar is going to be available for guests today, too, special. For you, and that will be some fun runs for you as the CVA people. They get in so many runs that it really does benefit their skiing, and the coaches have said just that. We're going to get a report from Captain Kip here in just a moment. He is skiing on vocals today. Well, he's not yet, but he's going to. And Kip, how do those skis feel?
These feel great. I have skied on them before. It's a great front face carver, really light wood core. Good ski, great ski. Yep. It's not one that you're gonna take in knee deep powder. I misspoke last time. Snubber's not open.
Okay.
Right. Snubber's not open yet. They're keeping an eye on it. You know, it's amazing because right here it doesn't feel like much wind at all. Every once in a while we get a puff, but. Up top, I was just talking to one of the mechanics that came down, because three T-bar, the T's were just right out straight, sideways, right at the top where you get off. So, still windy up top, and anything changes, we'll let you know.
All right. Well, thank you, Captain. We appreciate it, and thanks for your extra hard work stomping down the snow over there, too. You're a team player.
I am. It's all about the team.
Thank you so much, Cap. And he'll get a report a little bit later. Jess joins us here this morning, and we have got so much to talk about here, and I want to welcome you. Thanks for being here this morning.
Yes, thank you very much.
Happy Easter in advance.
Happy Easter to everyone, yes.
Now, this is going to be a new thing for you, Easter service, huh?
Yeah, I'm excited. Yeah, I've actually never been to a sunrise service.
No, they don't do that around the other resorts, huh?
No, I mean, the only sunrise service that I'm aware of from where I come from in Vermont is Stowe does a sunrise service, and Jay Peak does a sunrise service.
Cool.
Yeah, I don't know if Killington does one, but yeah. Well, that's cool.
Those specifics are 5 to 5:20 is going to be open?
Yes, yeah. So if you, one of the things that changed for this year or new this year is you do need a ticket. Mm-hmm. So tickets are free. So if you don't have a season pass or you need an RFID to go through the gate, you can either get it online, you can reserve it online right through the Sunrise Easter Service event listing on the website, the ticket office will be open. So Sarah will be there at 5 a.m., but you need to be prompt, not a morning to be leisure, because we have a lot of staff here to support the service.
Absolutely, so. And it's like a finely oiled machine.
Totally, yeah. So you can get your ticket. If you have trouble getting it online, you can go to the ticket office. She'll be there till 5:20. and then you need to hustle over to Super Quad to make sure you get on the lift, because they'll just run the lift until everybody is through, and then they'll stop the lift for right. the service. Yeah.
Yeah, that makes mm-hmm. it really
yeah.
special.
Yeah.
And so, and yeah, and you can't be late because it's dark.
It's dark, right, exactly.
And there's a lot of people there to guide
yeah,
you.
Yeah, so there's just a lot of logistics behind that. So we just want to make sure for everyone's safety, yeah, that we get everybody together, nobody gets lost or anything. Because, yeah, it's a sunrise service, yeah. and you're going up in the dark.
In years past, there's been a little get-together at Bullwinkle's after. Is that happening?
That is not, no. Okay. Yeah, right. yeah.
Just so we can
yeah, Bullwinkle's will be on normal operations right. tomorrow, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you can go online and get and
yeah, that, you can reserve online and it's free. So yeah, you just need a ticket or a season pass just to go through the gate.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Let's talk about Bucksaw. I
yeah.
know everybody is
right, right. So again, yeah, it's kind of one of those things, but I mean, you know, it's windy today, so it might not have run anyway.
Whatever.
So there's like that silver lining. But yeah, so as we all know, Bucksaw Express is a new lift. And what happens with all new lifts is the haul rope, so that the line that the lifts run on is called the haul rope, mm-hmm. and that stretches. It can stretch. So there's a tension system within the lift itself that usually compensates for that. But sometimes with the new rope, it stretches to the point where the tension system can't compensate for that. So unfortunately, we just need to address it, you know, for safety's sake. You know, we, of course, did all the calculations and tried our best to see, can we make it through Reg A? But, you know, for everyone's safety, we decided, you know what, let's just get it done. The other factor that really played into it was, and for all those kids out there that maybe want a job change, the lift industry is the way to go, I tell you what. You know, of course, there's like one dude in the world, right, that knows how to splice a cable, and he is in high demand. So when he gave us his availability, it was like, okay, we either do it or we roll the dice. And of course, we're not going to roll the dice with. So what you're watching is the original splice when we were, you know, sizing the rope. And that's the dude.
That's the dude. Truck out in the
parking
lot.
Yeah. So he is in high demand, and when he says he has time for you, you do it. And yeah,
maybe you even got a favor Easter weekend.
I know. He must work like 8 days a week during the winter, you know. But yeah, so it's kind of one of those things, and we appreciate everyone's understanding and patience. So it'll be closed, you know, today and tomorrow. And then we'll, with any luck, we'll be opening it up again on Monday.
Right.
So, and then it'll be good for the rest of the season.
Understandable yeah. why yep. that choice was made.
Yeah.
Now, let's talk about some snow stats.
Oh,
we got more snow
coming. I know. Huh? So this looks like another whopper coming in Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Fingers crossed, because last weekend, it's like, take us back. What a treat it was.
Yeah.
And yeah, just a little snow. People really come out. I mean, there was such a pent-up demand for just some, you know, some good skiing, and that was some quality Western-style,
oh.
Utah-style pow. I mean, talk about a treat. So with that being said, those that were here, it was quite the day.
Yes,
back-to-back. We were super busy. And thanks to our shuttle, our parking attendants, I mean, we were really stretched thin, ops, like everyone. It was just game on, right? So we had 37 inches in 4 days. So remember, we got the 14 inches on Thursday.
Right.
Then we had another 23 inches over the course of the weekend. So we had 37 inches, and those Saturday and Sunday were our top two skier visits of the season.
I can imagine.
Yeah,
because
it was right yeah. down to, I think at one point on Sunday I heard parking was down to hugs or something. So I didn't venture out once I was here. I was like, I'm not losing my spot.
Well, no, and a lot of
it
people
was every
like
man
that.
For themselves.
Yeah.
So you know, it's cool. And this week, you know, we could see another, who knows, 12 to 18 inches, which is just like, yeah, bring it on, right?
Well, we had a practice run. We're ready.
Right, right. Yeah. Well, and I mean, that's what we're known for, right?
Yeah.
Our spring skiing.
Absolutely.
So, yeah.
And March used to be the snowiest month and
right.
may be coming back.
Well, fun fact,
yeah.
as I was crunching, you know, some of those snowfall stats, we, season to date, you know, not including the two inches that we got, We're at 155 inches for the season. Last year, this time, we were about 170. So, you know, not too far behind. Out of that 35 inches that we got, that represented almost 40% of our season-to-date snowfall. Crazy.
Yeah.
And then March alone, we've received 60 inches of snow, which represents over 60% of our season-to-date snowfall. So March still is the snowiest month, fact, here for this season. But, it's great.
Now, I want, does that include what the snowmakers made?
No,
so
natural.
Those would be,
that's
those
our
would
natural,
be extra.
Yeah, that's our natural snow accumulation. We don't ever, it's hard to measure, you know, with snow piles and everything. We'd be out there like huge things. So no, snowmaking doesn't count. Natural accumulation counts. That counts towards our annual snowfall.
So eclipse is coming.
Yes.
What do
so,
we expect?
Yeah,
what
we just had an emergency planning meeting with the town, and we are prepared. It's a comprehensive plan. Everybody's tracking it. This won't catch us by surprise. You know, the wild card that we have to really consider that, you know, we can only do so much and plan for so much is, you know, this isn't a ticketed event. So quite frankly, you know, it's just like, okay, here we go. You know, we're just going to plan for it. So, you know, as far as we're concerned, we are going to operate as a normal ski day. A perfect example of that, we were going back and forth with ops on closing the lift for the eclipse, like, you know, for like an hour and then doing extended time. And, you know, quite frankly, it just was like, how is this any different from loading the lift in the dark for tomorrow morning or, you know, a little an afternoon in December, you know, early season skiing. And, you know, when we're watching YouTube videos and everything of really what to think about the eclipse and how it really impacts the light, it doesn't get totally dark. It's like a shadow, you know, dark. It's like, you know, your evening sunset kind of dark. So we're just going to roll with it. We're just going to keep lifts going. We feel like, you know, if there was an emergency on snow, it just feels easier because we know how to respond to that with all lifts going. So normal ski day, we will keep the super quad open till 4:20. As far as some important things to note, so when, you know, you look at the website under spectating info, you know, please keep in mind that parking is first come, first serve. We're not charging for parking. But we will close the access road because the worst thing that could happen is it starts to get congested. Emergency vehicles couldn't get up here.
Makes sense.
Couldn't get out. So, you know, we will shut off the access road. We will shut off the outdoor center parking too, if it comes to that. You know, in working with local authorities, we'll have border control here. I mean, everybody's going to be from Rangeley to the border, you know, just making sure that it's controlled chaos, right?
Pretty exciting.
It's so exciting. I mean, it's going to be such a unique opportunity, like just a unique thing. How special is it, you know?
So, totally eclipse. And the other thing is, of course, the glasses.
Those
are so important.
So important, So on the website, you'll see, you know, just safety tips on how to watch the solar eclipse safely. We will be selling glasses that weekend. You know, we do have a limited supply. So if you feel so inclined to buy your own, please go right ahead.
And the library has some too.
Okay, great. Yeah. So perfect. Yeah, so if you want to buy them from us, absolutely. We probably will sell out. So, you know, maybe just plan a little ahead.
They'll be souvenirs.
Exactly. They have a little Sugarloaf logo on them. So, of course they do. And, yeah, so we have Orno Brewing here. We have tons of music. We're going to have this octopus stage up at Bowinkles. It's just it's going to be so cool. So all we need is the weather to cooperate.
All we need is the weather. Stay with us, Jess. We're going to come right back and talk more and the exciting stuff. We'll be right back.
The floor you choose can be more than just beautiful. It can also make a difference. By being environmentally sustainable and better for the planet, it can last longer and be cleaner and healthier for your home. We care about the same things you do, which is why at Allwood Floors, we only use responsibly sourced, real hardwood and bamboo. And because we know the floor you choose can make a difference.
All wood is available exclusively to this region here at Jordan Lumber. Please come down and see what we have. Ask for myself, Brian, or Alyssa.
Ski in, ski out at Sugarloaf Inn for unmatched on-mountain convenience. Boot up in the comfort of your room, head down to your private ski locker, and you'll be on the chairlift in no time. After you spend your day making turns at the loaf, head back to the inn for après. With the Shipyard Brewhouse on site to serve you breakfast, lunch, and dinner, you'll be fueled up throughout your stay. See you soon for your Slopeside stay!
Welcome to the Maine Ski and Snowboard Museum. Great location right here on the access road at Sugarloaf. Come on by. Our mission statement is to celebrate, preserve, and share the history and heritage of Maine skiing and snowboarding, and that's what we're trying to do. Check the website, MaineSkiandSnowboardMuseum.org, for more information. The phone number is on there. You can call, set up a time if you want, or you can come down when we're open. Hope to see you soon.
Located in Village West, the Sugarloaf Shop supports the iconic Sugarloaf Triangle that is one of the most recognizable logos in the world. Founded on the traditional logo t-shirt and now offering everything from high-end fashion items, home decor and logo hats, to bathing suits, children's clothes, Under Armour product lines, and original artwork and photography by local artists, the Sugarloaf Shop is your one stop for everything logo wear. Stop in and grab some loaf gear today.
All right, we are back at coming off the hill. As you can see, those clouds moving up there. We've got some gusts up there at the top and up to 60 miles per hour. So currently, we have got lifts on hold. What we do have running, Moosecalator, Sawduster, Skidway, and the T-Bar will run eventually. The CVA T-Bar, Go Big Dogs, I'm going to share that with all of our guests. That's going to be happening. And how late is the lift running today, Jess?
If we can get everything going, 4:20, it'll be a spring Saturday. Yeah. So the rest of the lifts close at 3:50, and Super Quad every Saturday now is open till 4:20.
Right.
And over last weekend, we kept it open. We kept it open Monday because it was just incredible skiing. So we get it.
Yeah,
we're skiers.
There's nothing you want more than to provide that,
exactly, that
experience.
Exactly.
Now, I know you're a big fan of dogs.
Yes, I have a big powder hound as well. His name is Leo. So Leo's a little jealous of some of the attention that one of our other fellow team members is getting. Winston. For anyone that knows Sugarloaf, you definitely have seen Winston around. And he is our furriest member of the IT team. And so he goes around and accompanies IT to fix, you know, whatever problems there may be. And as everyone knows, we're a part of the Icon Pass. And Icon, from time to time, you know, runs these different competitions. So this year, they're running the Bark Racket. And Winston was nominated and was accepted into the competition. So he originally was competing against 16 other pups.
Mm.
And the funny thing is, which is really cute, you know, all the other dogs are like Avi dogs and patrol dogs. And there's Winston, you know, professional IT computer dog.
Yeah.
So he's actually done pretty well. Right now he's in the top four. So we need your help because it's a close call. He's up against, it seems like, Annie, who's the other top winner. She's an Avi dog.
Yeah.
So it's between Annie and Winston in this last bracket. So we need you to vote. If you're on Instagram, please go to either the Sugar Sugarloaf story or the Icon story, yeah. And then you can just click right through and you can vote for Winston. Yeah. So we appreciate the support.
IT can be hairy at times. Sorry, that's all I could come up with. Gosh, you brought us right up to date. Anything else we should know, sir?
Well, I mean, that's right. it's one of those mornings, more coffee. No, it's a good morning to either get your skis tuned, go shopping, you know, just kind of wave
sales.
It out. Sales. We have tons of sales going on right now, both on our demo skis, just anything that you could want in Sugarloaf Shop, in Downhill Supply. So, yeah, it's a great day to just get organized and do some spring shopping.
Thank you so much for all your great information this morning,
Jess.
We appreciate it.
We'll
take a break. We'll be back. Julie Swain joins us, and we're talking about more deals. Stay with us.
The WSKI TV 17 Weather Report is brought to you by Mountainside Real Estate. Visit them in the Village or online at sugarloafmountainside.com. Good morning, skiers and riders, Sugarloaf and Carabasset Valley. Time to take a check of your latest local forecast. You can find this and much more at our website, WSKITV.com, including streaming and much more. And it's going to be a windy day today, especially this morning. We'll see sunshine start to poke through as the day goes on, 32 to 34. For your base temperatures of the west wind, 10 to 20 miles an hour. Summer temperatures, 23 to 25, with a gusty west-northwest breeze causing issues first thing. So stay tuned to the Mountain Report. We'll keep you updated on what's happening outside. For the day on Sunday, we'll wake up with some clouds, but things should clear out to sunny skies by the afternoon. A high of 38 at the base. Summit temperatures topping out right around 30 degrees, the upper 20s. And we'll still have a noticeable breeze across the hill, so just be aware of that. First day of April, we're looking for sunny skies, a high of 43 degrees. Tuesday, increase in clouds with a high of 40. And then Wednesday, looks like another snowstorm headed into our area, which is some great news. We'll keep skiing and riding right into the spring. Birchwood Interiors bringing you your trail report. Check them out in Village West. 149 trails to ski and ride on. 10 lifts getting you to 41 groomed trails. We'll see loose, granular, and variable conditions out there if you can get out on the hill. First thing this morning, scheduled winds, weather, and conditions permitting, Snubber, Sawduster, Skidway, and the Mooskalator, as well as Skyline and Double Runner East, and the Super Quad at 8:30, King Pine and Whiffletree at 8:30 as well, servicing the east side. And make note, Bucksaw Express is closed today and tomorrow. Timberline, winds, weather, and conditions permitting, opening at 9 a.m. Timberline, Bridal Chain, Tote Road, King's Landing, Hayburner, Haywire, Comp Hill, and Narrow Gauge on the groomers list last night, as well as Spillway, Sluice, Gondola Line, and Wedge, as well as Hallback and Ramdown on the east side, lower east side trails like Two-Haul, Whiffletree, Cruiser, Lower Buckboard, Slasher, Pole Line, Springboard, and Rollway, and Scoot, Windrow, Horseshoe, and West Mountain over on the west side of the mountain, as well as the new Bucksaw Trail to get you back down to the parking lot. And Lord Winter's Way, Candyside Boardwalk, the Landing, Birches, and Snowbrook around the base area, and all the terrain parks get smoothed out as well. The uphill route is open. Just follow the designated route. And down to Sugarloaf Outdoor Center, they're still holding on. They've been grooming out there. Things are firming up, though, with the cooler temperatures and the wet snow. The Anti-Gravity Complex, great spot for indoor activity, as well as the Sugarloaf Sports and Fitness Center right off of Mountainside Road or the Snubber Trail. And today is Clem and Roland Began. They're having a little shindig for them, 1 o'clock to 2:30 at the Carabasset Valley Public Library and Community Center in the Began Community Room. And there's an open house on Elderberry Way today, offered up by Liz Walker-Feeney, and also Fodder's Market and Hardware. If you're looking for any of your Easter supplies, they've got it right up on Main Street in Stratton. Make note, they will be closed on Easter Sunday. And a great Easter sunrise service on Sunday. Get up early. Go grab a ticket and be at the Super Quad to load at 5:30. And it's always a good time to get up there early on the Super Quad to celebrate Easter. Quad Cam, check it out so you can see what's happening at the mountain in real time with some weather information on there as well. And we've got our mountain report this weekend, Saturday and Sunday mornings, 7:30 to 9 a.m. We've got Watch and Win Reggae Weekend. And there's plenty of ways to watch us right here on Channel 17, as well as streaming 24/7 at WSKITV.com, the Spectrum app, as well as a Roku channel, and check us out on social media as well. Make the most of it today, folks.
Hi, I'm Deb Pierce. I've been a Sugarloafer since 1975. My style is really low pressure and nurturing. I like helping people through the whole process, make them feel comfortable. I'm a good listener. This market is crazier than I've ever seen. So if you're looking to buy or sell, please come see me here right in the Village. We're here every day, 9 to 5.
We're back. It's the Mountain Report, 28 degrees currently, Mountainside Real Estate, bringing us live quad cam shot. And we're looking at some wind today. All lifts are on wind hold, but except Muskellata, Sawdusters, Skidway, and eventually CVA T-Ball will run for guests as well. So keep that in mind. Have another cup of coffee. Maybe do some shopping. You know, there is a wonderful place where you can do some shopping in Kingfield, and it's right on the main street, and some of the staff there is just the nicest people. You should go see them. And Julie is one of them. Good morning, Julie.
Good
Julie
morning.
Swain. The main shop in downtown Kingfield is like happening down there. You've got a lot of people doing some shopping down there.
Yeah, it's been busy.
Yeah.
It's been good.
Now,
yeah.
what are you wearing today?
Oh, this is my shirt from Hawaii last year.
I was going to say, it's a departure from what you've been doing.
Well, I have to go to my past job, and then I'm actually going over to Range to set up that shop for next weekend.
Smokes.
So this is kind of like my work clothes going on here.
Yeah.
I'm sorry I didn't dress up for my appearance.
No, I was just trying to figure, Maui, look at that. Those on sale?
One-way tickets to Hawaii.
One-way tickets, a long swim.
Yeah.
So there are a lot of great items down there. And you have got representation from many artisans and things that you guys make yourselves. And what are you showing us today?
Well, today I brought our Eclipse t-shirt.
Ah.
My graphic designer came up with this design. And we have it in women's cut and men's cut.
Mm-hmm.
And it has the latitude and longitude of Sugarloaf. This one, I think, is Rangeley. But I just wanted to show, this is the unisex. Some people like the crew neck.
Yeah.
I've had a lot of ladies ask me for V-neck, so I said, what the heck, we'll have it. $20. $20 t-shirt. We're going back to vintage pricing.
Right?
And we have some of the Eclipse glasses, too.
I was going to ask,
Yeah, we're getting more in on Monday, but we still have some stock in the Kingfield store. So if you're interested and you need those glasses, the early bird gets the worm. And they're open at 10 a.m. this morning.
10 a.m.
Yes.
And your hours are?
Well, we are open. It varies. Friday and Saturday, we open 10 to 5. Sunday, we're open 11 to 3.
Mm-hmm.
And then Wednesday and Thursday, we're open 11 to 5. And so just show up around 10 or 11. We're usually there. And we actually just slashed all the prices on the Sugarloaf t-shirts and sweatshirts.
I saw.
Yeah, I think the t-shirts are $15, and you can get a sweatshirt for $28. So really good quality. Just end of season sale. We're closing out some of those pattern, the styles and the graphics, and getting ready for next year.
Right.
So might as well come in. And actually, we even have a $5 t-shirt.
Wow.
That, it was from last year, and I'm like, let's just blow these out of here. So we have a lot of good deals.
Crazy Julie. Welcome to Crazy Julie's.
I know, like Weird Al, Weird
We're marking
Julie's.
Them down and moving them out.
Pretty much,
Now, what about the Eclipse? You're going to be open?
Oh, yeah. We are going to be open all weekend, and then Monday morning we'll be open till 1.
Yeah.
So very exciting, getting ready for all those people that are going to be coming in.
What do you think? It's hard to, we don't know.
I don't know. It's been very hyped up. I know Rangeley's been working on it since last fall, been promoting it, and that's all you see in the news, and it's supposedly we're going to get a ton of people. The police and the local police and fire department are getting ready in case, for potential problems just with all these people coming in. I think there's going to be a lot of day traffic is what I think.
Carpool.
Yeah.
You want a carpool. And Chief Lopez will be on tomorrow.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Andy's volunteered to get tased. And so he's going to be on tomorrow.
Well, that'll be a good show.
Yeah, he's volunteered to get tased.
And... Wait,
no, you, not me. Oh, well, wait a minute. I turned that around, didn't I? Well, we have got Captain Kip with us. Can
okay,
we take
sure.
a moment to talk to Kip? Hey, Kip, you know, there's a lot of great things on sale down at the Made in Maine shop in Kingfield. Maybe you need to get an Eclipse t-shirt.
I probably do.
Yeah.
I can't believe you got your glasses? I don't have one yet. Yes. Yeah. Do they have them in extra large?
Of course.
Of course. We have up to 3X. So.
Oh, well, I don't think I need that. But yes, great. That's perfect. What a great idea.
Have that extra room.
Yeah,
you know?
Growing.
Yes, well, there's all sorts of stuff you got to put underneath it this time of year.
Yeah, I've seen
days. Somebody skiing it around. Well, you'd be somebody at the transfer station with that t-shirt, wouldn't you? Yeah, I'm telling you. Well, Greg, I did get some information just recently that there is no uphill climbing skiing today. So,
okay.
If you're thinking about putting on the skis and the skins and hiking up, that's because there's no ski patrol up there. They've shut that off, so there's no uphill. And we'll just have to keep an eye on what the wind does. It hasn't. Nothing has changed. It's actually increased a little bit up there. Although, you know, right down here, I must be in quite a league because we don't get much in here every once in a while to puff. But up top, it's still quite violent. So I do know that some first trackers went up and with the ski patrol, and they said it was a little bit tough, you know, with all that wind, a little bit tough because when they groomed, you know, everything they groom fluffs it up. It ends up in a northwest breeze, ends up in Kingfield. You're probably going to have to shovel your backyard, Greg, when you get home.
Julie's going to have to shovel out front.
Oh, yeah.
Right. I was in the Downhill Supply Company, and sometimes life shines on you, even on days when you can't go skiing. And the vocal folks are in there, and they have a next year's Deacon. It's called Peregrine. And next year's on. So I got a pair put in my locker. I'll be able to ski on those tomorrow and give a report on next year's ski. That's kind of exciting.
World's largest locker, Kip.
Yeah, well, it's got to be. I had to throw a few things out just to get those in. And if you're looking for some of the glasses for the eclipse, I believe they're going to go tomorrow, Monday or Tuesday. You'll be able to get them in the Downhill Supply Company.
There you go. Great information.
Right.
Well, I'm sorry you didn't get a chance to try those skis, but you did try them once before, and
they were good skis. Yeah, the other ones, they were pretty good skis, Greg. I mean, they're good front face, good price point, good front face carver. If you're staying out of the trees or in deep powder, then that's a ski for you. It's a great one. You can demo that tomorrow.
Perfect. Thanks, Kip. We appreciate it. And thanks for your report today. And thanks for all the work you did over there patting the snow down for him, too.
Well, sort of a renaissance man. I do it all.
A renaissance man. On that note, we'll leave it. All right. Thanks.
We'll see everyone
talk
tomorrow.
To the Downhill Supply Company, and Julie Swain is with us, and we're talking about the Made in Maine shop.
Yeah, let's take a quick break.
We're going to take a quick break, and we'll talk more with Julie Swain here this morning.
Who's tired of standing in the beer aisle trying to make sense of 1,000 different IPAs? Can't there just be an easy choice? Shipyard's American Pale Ale cuts through the noise. It is the American Craft Classic. Perfectly balanced and bursting with just the right amount of modern hop flavors. This is a beer for beer lovers that just don't need to overthink it. Delicious, flavorful, craft you can rely on. Shipyard APA, the perfect choice every time.
Backco Financial is an independent wealth management firm here in Falmouth. We pride ourselves on building trustworthy, long-term relationships so that we can be the first call our clients make when they have questions about investments, finance, and life changes. Our team has a variety of expertise and professional designations that allow us to provide holistic financial planning and tailored asset management. Backco Financial, honest, independent, experienced.
Hi.
Hi, we're at the White Wolf Inn, I think.
Yeah, we are. But we have to know that, but we can't know that because we're wearing our eclipse glasses.
We're doing a simulated eclipse right now, staring right into the light.
And it works.
Yeah.
Can't see a thing except the little gray balls.
And how many people you think are coming, Sandy? What do you think?
Well, from what we hear from all friends, family, and people we haven't heard from in years, the place is going to be packed from wall to wall. I don't even think you can find standing place in a field up here.
That would be an event, right?
And I think it's more than an event.
Yeah. So you're going to be here to, you'll be open, and I know you've got some special things, including, well, I can't see them now, but I did earlier.
Right. Well, if you come in and get a Wolf Burger, you get to have a pair of some eclipse glasses, free. And then we also have the White Wolf Eclipse t-shirts, specially done for us by Dan Pelletier. It's his design. And Black Bear Graphics, our local graphics company, did the actual printing. They did a fabulous job, yeah.
And you brought a model.
Oh, yes, we brought a model over here.
Now, you got stickers too, right?
Oh, yeah, we got them all up here, all back here. So the design on the shirt, you can also get a sticker for your car, that your car made it up here for the eclipse and didn't crash.
That would add value, as opposed to this car climbed Mount Washington. Then you know the brakes are gone. It's not worth as much.
Right, yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Uh-huh.
So the White Wolf Inn will be, do you have any special eclipse?
Dinners?
Yeah, maybe,
black
some.
Black and chicken or something? Black?
I was thinking of something,
Yeah, like a blackened salmon. Yeah, we could do that for you.
I cooked this with my eyes closed.
Yes, I did. I burned it. No, I don't burn things. But yes, we do have special dinners. We are asking for reservations, please, for both the 7th and the 8th. I don't know of anybody up here. I don't think a single hotel has any rooms left that I know of. And if you're planning on coming out to eat with us that night, we're here to serve you. We've got great meals planned, but please make a reservation because we're going to have a guard at the door. Thank you. Yeah.
Now, when the last eclipse, when it was out in Colorado, the issue was people leaving. It wasn't the issue because they came sporadically, but they all wanted to leave right after.
Uh-uh.
Ain't happening.
No, not happening. This place is booked, so is everybody else up here for the 8th, too. Yeah. They're not leaving.
So the town the next morning could look like Lewiston did when they had the Grateful Dead concert with people camping out on people's front lawns. Who knows?
Oh, no, that's already being planned. Spillover Motel, if you would like to stand in their field to watch the eclipse, it's $30, I believe, and you get free popcorn and hot chocolate.
Right
down the road.
Yeah. So this is a huge event. You'll be open and feeding until you can't feed anymore.
You've got it.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And you don't have any rooms.
No. We are booked.
Well, there you have it. The whole story right here, and you're going to be at the center of everyone's attention right here in Stratton, in this area, right?
And a great view from our deck.
Well, come on and visit. Get yourself the shirt and more.
I get a memorabilia. You need some memorabilia to remember the event.
We are back. It is the Mountain Report. Glimmers of, I see shadows. We're expecting a little bit of sunshine here this afternoon, but not really this morning. No uphill travel here this morning. Muscalator, Sawduster, Skidway, and eventually the CVAT are going to run for guests. As you can see, the sun is trying to get out, and let's hope we see it today, and let's hope we see it tomorrow morning for Easter service. And Julie Swain is here with us, the main shop right downtown Kingfield, and she's all swagged out. She's got her glasses on.
Guess what I'm here to talk about.
Those look very, very nice on you, by the way. You can't see anything.
Can't see anything.
Well, we're all excited to see the darkness. And you got to have a celebrity, a T-shirt.
Yep, $20 T-shirt and women's cut or men's cut or unisex.
Yep.
Has the latitude and longitude of Sugarloaf. And a cool design. I like this. It's just different.
Right. Yeah. Well, one of the many great items that you have down there.
Oh, yeah.
You'll be open today, so people can go down there and do a little bit of shopping.
Yeah. We'll be open 10 to 5 today, so
You know, we have the Refresh store next door, so you can get a smoothie or something to eat, or Annie's, get something to eat, and go shopping. So it's a nice little downtown, and we're right on the corner of the downtown area. So
can't miss it.
No.
And in Rangeley, if you happen to be going up that way.
I am going to go over to Rangeley. I'm all my gear to get that store ready. It's been closed this winter, so got to get ready for next weekend. It's going to be a big weekend. Yeah.
What do you do in your spare time?
I sleep.
Oh, good answer. You deserve that.
If I have any downtime, you can find me on my couch in the loft with both my animals on top of the blanket on top of me, you know.
Oh, Teddy.
And Leo, my cat.
Teddy and Leo. Well, there you go. Thanks, Julie. Thanks for joining us here this morning. Go down there and take advantage of the great deals. And
shout out to Maggie Swain.
Yeah. She is, tell us where she is now.
Right now she's at the Canadian Nationals in Nikiska. She and her teammate Morgan, the girls are there, and then they're headed to Sweden. They're going to go to a fist race, and then they're going to Junior Worlds over there. So hopefully we'll see how she does. No flu this year, this race, I hope, right?
Now, she has a GoFundMe page.
She does. We kind of ran out. I give her money every year for racing, and that ran out after the Olympics. So she's been responsible for racing fees and all that, and she's doing a GoFundMe, as you can see. And any support, you know, she loves all the support she's getting from the community, and anything anyone can do, big or small, or just a shout out to her, will keep her going.
Yeah, we want to see her succeed.
Yeah.
We need to help out in any way we can. So there's the Facebook.
That's what's great about the Sugarloaf community, you know.
Most generous.
Yeah, they are.
Well, there it is right there, and hopefully you will go, and she's on her way to be a champion.
Yes, well, she already is a
champion. She already is, but she is heading up the up the ladder, so to speak.
Yeah, and there's a lot of fierce competition. Those Canadians are tough.
Yeah.
It's, you know, they're like the best at ski cross right now.
It is. That's
Morgan and Maggie are right on their heels.
Yeah.
So, and this is Junior Worlds that they're going to. The Canadian Nationals are a little older. They do the World Cup. So this is good practice for the girls before they head off to that.
Well, when you have the flu and you come in ninth in the world, that's pretty good. So let's hope she's feeling great.
Let's see what she does without the flu.
Thanks, Julie.
Yeah, thank you.
Nice to see you. And stop on by and take advantage of the great deals. We'll be right back.
WSKI TV 17 Weather Report is brought to you by Mountainside Real Estate. Visit them in the village or online at sugarloafmountainside.com.
Good morning, skiers and riders, Sugarloaf and Carabasset Valley. Time to take a check of your latest local forecast. You can find this and much more at our website, WSKITV.com, including streaming and much more. And it's going to be a windy day today, especially this morning. We'll see sunshine start to poke through as the day goes on, 32 to 34 for your base temperatures, with a west wind 10 to 20 miles an hour. Summit temperatures 23 to 25 with a gusty west northwest breeze causing issues first thing. So stay tuned to the Mountain Report. We'll keep you updated on what's happening outside. For the day on Sunday, we'll wake up with some clouds, but things should clear out to sunny skies by the afternoon. A high of 38 at the base, summit temperatures topping out right around 30 degrees, the upper 20s, and we'll still have a noticeable breeze across the hill, so just be aware of that. First day of April, we're looking for sunny skies, a high of 43 degrees. Tuesday, increase in clouds with a high of 40. And then Wednesday, looks like another snowstorm headed into our area, which is some great news. We'll keep skiing and riding right into the spring. Birchwood Interiors bringing you your trail report. Check them out in Village West. 149 trails to ski and ride on. 10 lifts getting you to 41 groomed trails. We'll see loose, granular, and variable conditions out there if you can get out on the hill. First thing this morning, scheduled winds, weather, and conditions permitting, Snubber, Sawduster, Skidway, and the Mooskalator, as well as Skyline and Double Runner East, and the Super Quad at 8:30, King Pine and Whiffle Tree at 8:30 as well, servicing the east side. And make note, Bucksaw Express is closed today and tomorrow. Timberline, winds, weather, and conditions permitting, opening at 9 a.m. Timberline, Bridle Chain, Tote Road, King's Landing, Hayburner, Haywire, Comp Hill, and Narrow Gauge on the groomers list last night, as well as Spillway, Sluice, Gondola Line, and Wedge, as well as Hallback and Ramdown on the east side, lower east side trails like Two Hall, Whiffle Tree, Cruiser, lower buckboard, slasher, pole line, springboard, and rollway. And Scoot, Windrow, Horseshoe, and West Mountain over on the west side of the mountain, as well as the new Bucksaw Trail to get you back down to the parking lot. And Lower Winter's Way, Candy Side Boardwalk, the Landing, Birches, and Snowbrook around the base area, and all the terrain parks get smoothed out as well. The uphill route is open. Just follow the designated route. And down to Sugarloaf Outdoor Center, they're still holding on. They've been grooming out there. Things are firming up, though, with the cooler temperatures and the wet snow. The Anti-Gravity Complex, great spot for indoor activity, as well as the Sugarloaf Sports and Fitness Center right off of Mountainside Road or the Snubber Trail. And today is Clem and Roland Began. They're having a little shindig for them, 1 o'clock to 2:30 at the Carabasset Valley Public Library and Community Center in the Began Community Room. And there's an open house on Elderberry Way today, offered up by Liz Walker-Feeney, and also Fodder's Market and Hardware. If you're looking for any of your Easter supplies, they've got it right up on Main Street in Stratton. Make note, they will be closed on Easter Sunday. And a great Easter sunrise service on Sunday. Get up early, go grab a ticket, and be at the Super Quad to load at 5:30. And that's always a good time to get up there early on the Super Quad to celebrate Easter. Quad Cam, check it out so you can see what's happening at the mountain in real time with some weather information on there as well. And we've got our mountain report this weekend, Saturday and Sunday mornings, 7:30 to 9 a.m. We've got Watch and Win Reggae Weekend, and there's plenty of ways to watch us right here on Channel 17, as well as streaming 24/7 at WSKITV.com, the Spectrum app, as well as the Roku channel, and check us out on social media as well. Make the most of it today, folks.
I'm Michelle DeFrosia. I've been the business manager here at Birchwood Interiors for over a decade. I'm part of a team that I'm very proud of. Our company's goal to treat every customer who walks through the door as our best friend isn't just a slogan. Our clients really do become our friends. The trust that our clients put in us is refreshing in today's world. All of us at Birchwood Interiors seek every day to work with integrity and professionalism that will continue to earn that trust. We're in Village West, so come on in, pull up a sofa, and see what we can do for you.
We're back. It's a Mountain Report, and wow, we got the whole family here, and we have got some coffee, and we're like celebrating in here, huh? Now, I'm going to start to, we want to introduce everyone first. Tell us what your name is.
My name's Izzy.
Izzy, and how old are you, Izzy?
I'm 8, and yeah.
Just 8. Yeah, that's 8. And you are
Abby.
Abby, and you just lost a tooth.
I'm 6.
You're 6 years old.
Yeah.
Now both of you are in bubble cuffers and CVA, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And are you skiers, snowboarders?
I'm a skier.
Yeah.
Skier.
Mm-hmm. Now, who's your coach?
My coach is Andy.
Yeah, Andy Ricker?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
And her coach is? Dave Ward.
Oh, man. They were just on the show. Dave Ward and Andy.
Shout out to Brian because he was one of my coaches before I had Andy.
Oh, and then you got an upgrade?
Mm-hmm.
I'm just kidding. Just a little joke. That was a little joke, a little Andy joke there. Now, do you enjoy it? You've got a lot of friends in there. Huh?
Yeah, I have like some of my Stratton friends that go to my same class are in CVA, and One of them is in Brian's class.
Yeah.
Well, like, yeah, one of them is in Brian's class, and one of them is in this girl named Lanny's class.
Oh, sure. Lanny Kepler.
Yeah. My BFF AOE, best friend for all of eternity, is in Lanny's class.
I love it. Go Bobcats?
Yeah.
Yeah. You go Stratton Schools?
Yep.
Yeah, and I asked you about the coat of arms because we just went up there and interviewed and saw them all displayed up there, huh?
I think you interviewed Ruby and Ben.
I did.
And in my class, Charlotte and Zion.
I did. Nice. Wow, you guys got good memories, huh? Now, do you help out down at Mountainside Grocers?
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Because I'm usually not there. Because I'm usually at school.
Right. Right. But you brought some stuff here to show us. You're kind of in sales, huh?
So we have a giant dragon.
That's cool.
It's.
What is it?
It's So this dragon can come from that egg, but this dragon didn't come from that egg. Mom, did this dragon come from an egg?
Well, it was a much larger egg, but
yeah.
They're 3D printed dragons.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
And then I have a dragon egg that contains 3 dragons in it.
No way. So what came first, the egg or the dragon?
The egg. The egg.
Greg, yeah. I got to give a shout out. Yeah. Emily Rose, we got to say hi.
What happened?
Nano and Popo, and she wanted us to say hi, Emily.
Hi, Emily. I wish you would have come, Emily. But that's all right.
Next time. She said.
She's 3.
She's 3.
Oh, you got such a nice family here. So, yeah, do you guys help out with testing some of these great toy and candy items?
Yes.
Well, I'm the candy manager,
and I'm
the first bought the store.
Yeah.
We thought that I would be a good candy manager, and she would be a good toy. Mm-hmm. Toy manager.
Yeah.
And we have, I think, one of the candies. I don't know.
Yeah,
you brought some stuff.
We have these.
Oh, we brought
keys.
That stuff.
Yeah, what is it? What is that?
And I will not survive without these. These are amazing.
Me and Izzy love these, and so does Emily. But
I usually drink the most of them.
What do you like best about it?
I like best about it how, like, there's little, like, this bubbles. Is popping boa. So, like, there's bubbles in the bottom.
No way.
And, like, it's covered in this, like, stuff. I don't know what it's covered
it's
in.
It's like,
and you can gel. Like, and you just like smush it with your tongue, and it's, yes, and like, it is amazing.
There's little bubbles inside, bubble tea. Yeah.
Wow.
It's Joba. Joba bubbles.
Where could we buy some of that?
At our store.
Yeah. Yeah. So you have glasses too. Did you bring glasses for the eclipse?
Yes, we have solar eclipse glasses.
Oh yeah, you guys got to have those. Make sure you wear those.
Yeah, you don't want to look at the sun.
Yeah. Don't be that person. You know, people.
I can't see anything.
Yeah, well, you can't now, and we'll see a lot of that later. But it's going to be a big day. Are you guys excited? Do you have a half day of school or a full day?
On the day of the solar eclipse, do we have a half day?
Yes.
The day of the solar eclipse. Our school has a half day.
Yeah.
And Sugarloaf's got a big party, so we'll come join the party. Huh?
Right?
Sugarloaf's got a big all-day party.
Yeah. How much is it going to cost to park down in your lot?
Come on in.
We really don't know what to expect.
It's
a surprise.
That's a thing we don't know.
Right.
But things are pretty happening down there right now, you know? Mm-hmm. You got a lot going on down there.
If we judge it by all the hotels being sold out, it should be a busy weekend.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Well, you got plenty of beer, plenty of booze.
We'll get the beer and booze.
Yeah. And plenty of jolly.
Joba tea.
Oh, look at that.
It's Joba.
It's really pretty good. It's a tea, and it's flavored with real fruit juice. So it's fruit juice tea, and then these little popping bubbles. It's very popular with the Stratton school kids right now.
Yeah. Wow. Like, my whole class brings them in every single day. Like,
the day that I...
Sorry, teachers.
Yeah?
Sorry, teachers.
No, not sorry, teachers.
It doesn't have any caffeine in it, does it?
Well, it's tea, so it has a minimal amount.
Oh, a little bit.
It's green tea, but an energy drink.
You guys seem like you have a lot of energy.
No energy.
That's Captain Kip right there. Yeah. And you've got all the a lot of Easter supplies. Now, if the Easter Bunny doesn't come to someone's house, can someone come get some Peeps and things like that? Do you have any of that?
Yeah.
We have lots of Easter candy. We don't have any Peeps right now.
I never liked Peeps, a little short. To be honest with you.
We have a few Peeps, maybe a few left.
We have
but we do have some candy. We have lots of Easter flowers.
Peeps are just filler in your basket.
I don't really understand Peeps either, but some people really love them.
I don't even like marshmallows.
They're a lot like marshmallows, aren't they?
Yeah, they are marshmallows.
Yeah, yeah.
They're bunny-shaped marshmallows.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't even like
them. Well, you guys, now what grade are you in again?
I'm in third.
And you are in?
Kindergarten.
Huh? Wow, you guys really speak well, huh? You guys must do well in school, huh? Do you get straight A's?
Our teachers don't grade our papers.
They don't grade like that anymore. You get a number these days.
Oh, well, I'm a little out of date.
Pretty close, though.
Yeah, I wish they didn't have grades back when I went to school. So what are your hours? You opened, of course, for the eclipse, and let's talk about your regular hours.
Well, we're going to start setting back to the old 7 a.m. to 8 after ski season's over. But
after reggae.
Yeah, after, you know, the big push. But Friday and Saturday nights, we're staying open till 10. Making sure we're still available for people rolling into town.
Yeah.
But we're going to get back to the 7 to 8 for the, you know, the off season.
Yeah. So we're looking forward to some busy times. Are you still looking for any help down there?
Always looking for help. Yeah. And again, if you're just coming out of working on the mountain and you want a day, we'll work it into the schedule. It'll make it easier for other people. We stop by, let us know if you're available, and we definitely will put you to work.
You always have great music.
We're trying.
Yeah.
Even that's when my you're playlist. Singing.
You want to do some Stones for us this morning?
No, I'm good.
No, all right.
But you can catch it anytime you're in there. I usually don't care when I'm in the store. And
I hide in the aisle and listen.
Yeah. It's great if you open the, you know, to get some milk and you hear, like, you know, some my Rolling Stones or some Metallica
that.
Even. You just never really know with his playlist what's going to come on.
I thought I heard Master of Puppets in a cooler.
And what other grocery store can you go in and listen to Master of Puppets?
Right.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Every now and then I have to be like, cut, next.
I just can't deal with the silence. Silence kills me.
Yeah, so. Yeah, you don't want that. Now, these flowers here, these something that you're
we have
available?
Some right now we have some live daffodils and tulips and I think two or one Easter lily left.
Yeah.
And then we have some really nice cut flowers right now. Really beautiful bouquets.
Yeah.
And we've been trying to have flowers more regularly. We have a bunch coming for Mother's Day, but that's a ways off.
Right, right.
Ski season will be over. But
Mother's Day, remember? Mm. Mother's Day.
Don't forget.
Oh, we got another one coming right up, though.
Right.
Mommy's birthday.
Oh.
That's this week. Mommy's birthday
week. 5 days away.
Are you going to give her the day off?
Probably not.
Double time, right?
No, everyone. When is the birthday so everyone can come in and wish you a happy birthday?
4-4 is mommy.
4-4.
We have a birthday deal. Yeah. And mommy is 4-4.
Yeah.
Daddy's 10-10. Izzy?
9-9.
Abby?
12-12.
Wow.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy.
Just screwed it all up. She was 19.
Maybe that's why she didn't want to come.
Yeah. No, she's extra special.
Yeah. Well, yeah. You guys are all extra special. Well, we appreciate you coming on here. Happy Easter to you. Now, I know you guys will be getting up early and going to Easter service up on the hill.
Maybe.
Because you got to get up early. Are you an early riser?
Yes.
Sure. That means no.
No.
And that means no.
No.
Well, anyway.
Answer pillow.
Yeah. Well, you know, people like it. It's better than Peeps.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, thank you all for coming. And Mountainside Grocers, located right there at the base of the access road. And gosh, you guys are doing such a great job down there. And we are have just noticed the friendliness, and we've noticed a lot more different products down there. So we really appreciate what you do down here.
A store of the people for the people.
Oh, man.
Making shopping great again.
I'm having the hair on my arms is standing on end.
I can't make it.
Like
he
you've
just
never
comes
seen
up with
before.
This stuff.
Well, thank you, guys. We appreciate it. And we're going to take a break. We'll be back.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter, everyone. Thanks for coming, guys.
Woo-hoo. I didn't know you were.
Thank you.
What are you thinking, Angel?
Angel's often picking out these really techie lines, like, I don't even see a way through. She sees a way through. I never know where she's going.
Yeah, so maybe that rock would be good.
Her confidence was quickly apparent. Like, first run, I was like, what, where is she going? Like, whoa, I would not go there. Like, I have no idea even where her line is.
Smoking! Smoking! Smoking. Come on down, see what we got smoking.
Do you find yourself suffering from advanced cabin fever, violently restless legs, active body syndrome? Maybe it's time you considered anti-gravity. Only anti-gravity has been clinically proven to cure you of the doldrums, boredom, and enhanced sagging of the bottom. Side effects of anti-gravity include giddiness, having too much fun, and getting into shape. Don't bother asking your physician if anti-gravity is right for you. Just come in today and try it for yourself.
Likes to drink good coffee. At Carabasa Coffee Company, we roast premium quality coffee beans from all over the world. Roasted to perfection in small batches, our coffee is always fresh. We offer large selection, including our specialty blends, organics, single origins, decaf, and flavor. Whether you like light, medium, or dark roasts, we have coffee to suit every taste. We offer flat rate shipping for online orders, and we ship fast. Carabasa Coffee Company. Drink good coffee.
Feel this cab moving, but I'm a little worried the machine is going to flip over in just a second ago. This is just insane. I'm trying to eat my lunch. I'm thinking about going down lower on the mountain. It's just crazy. You can't see nothing. The windshield won't take care of itself. My mirrors, as you can see, it grows solid. I can't even see out beside windows. And the heat is on full blast. It's shaking the machinery back and forth.
Man, I love this place.
Man, I love this place.
I love this place.
We love this place.
What's your favorite thing to eat here at the Bag?
Bag burger.
Bag burger.
Love the baked potato, actually. Half in the bag punch. I love the lifty lemonade.